welcome back. And if you tuned in late today, my very special guest is Dr. Roger Rhodes, and he is a counselor, and we do have a website up there for you. And we're talking about this coming year and how we can be positive. And we all know that the world is filled with sorrow and war thoughts and crimes, and if you turn on the news, you can become very depressed. But we can't change all of that. We can only change our little, where we live and ourselves. And Roger, you've brought out some very good points, and we need not to isolate, but to reach out to people. Find something you're interested in, volunteer, be productive, get involved in your kids' lives.
Yeah. You know. I want everybody to hear, everybody is wounded. Growing up in the world, something wounds you. Something happens with other people.
It's not a perfect
world.
And that's right.
It's an imperfect world. And we operate kind of spiritually in sharp objects. And eventually, one's going to wound us. And what the world's telling us is ignore the wound. And that's coming into 2:15. That's an issue too. Ignore the wound. I know you're wounded. And it's easy. When you're wounded, it's easy to isolate. Don't look at it. Don't touch it. I'll stay away from people. I won't have to deal with it. Everything will be okay. No, you'll spiritually have gangrene, and you're going to have to amputate the leg, okay? No, if it's wounded, get it out there. Clean it out. And part of the cleaning process is being around other people.
Well, you were mentioning when we were in the break about mm-hmm. the Bible story that
yes.
so apropos to what you're talking about.
Well, you know, God gives us messages, and one of the messages he's given us is about Nehemiah. Nehemiah was in a tough situation. He lived in one kingdom, and the Holy Kingdom's walls were broken down and in defeat, again, quote unquote, wounded, okay? And it looked like all had been lost. But God had gotten with him and said, let's go heal. Let's go make a difference. Sure, you're fine over here in this other kingdom. Sure, you're part of the royal court. Sure, you could sit here and everything be okay. But he put a desire in Nehemiah's heart of healing. And I think that's what God's doing to all of us. And what we miss, Peggy, is if we want to heal us, we got to be willing to heal other people. See, we keep thinking, well, isolate, it'll eventually get healed. No. Isolate, you get weird, you get more depressed, life looks terrible, it doesn't work. It's just like we're talking about with exercise. You got to get up, you got to put on the exercise equipment, you got to get out there and sweat. But if you do, you lose weight. It's the same thing we're talking about here. If I'm wounded, what I need to do is get out and get off of the focus of my wound and help other people's wounds. To get out there, and in Nehemiah's case in the Bible, rebuild the wall. Now, could God just put the wall back up? Yes, God could put the wall back up. But he's looking for our involvement. He's looking for our investment. And that's what this world needs more and more of, is investors. People who say, hey, I don't care if it's going to mess with my comfort zone. Good. If I go, I don't want to do that because it makes me uncomfortable. Good. Be uncomfortable. Get in people's lives. Get involved. Rebuild the wall. If you do that, you're being biblical, and God has said he'll heal. And there's a lot of people that are listening to this that could be healed, but they won't get off the couch.
So we have to make the effort. We have to take the first step.
There is the clear message. We've got to make the effort. We've got to get off the couch. We've got to put the effort in. If kind of the old idea, nothing ventured, nothing gained. If you go back in history, the history of America, people were comfortable. People didn't have to take a stand. People didn't have to step up. They didn't have to. They could have, you know, stayed in slavery in so many ways. But they said, no, we will not live wounded. We will not live depressed. We will not be isolated. Yes, it's hard to get up and get out. You know, it was hard for the revolutionary people. They could have just sat and drank tea in Boston. Everything had been okay. They'd still been slaves. But they said, we're not putting up with that. We're going to get out and we're going to march in the cold and we're going to fight against the oppressor and we're going to do what we need to do to move forward. And wow, that's where we are today. That's why we're the country we are today.
Yes, because
of the discomfort of our ancestors. And the Bible is very clear about that. If you don't read the Old Testament and the New Testament and say, hey, they had it easy. You know, those people, they were living on easy street. You know, those Israelites, man, they had the silk couches. No, they were in slavery. Imagine, here's a group of people that were in Egypt, and they were slaves, and they were having to make bricks. And Pharaoh wasn't a nice person. He wasn't concerned about, I wonder how the Israelites feel. No, he was whipping them at her. And God said, I hear your cries. I hear your prayers. And I will send a deliverer. And he's giving everybody out there a Moses moment where they can deliver. They can deliver their mood. They can come out of the slavery of depression. And anybody who's been depressed and stressed knows how oppressive that is. I don't want to make light of that. It is a terrible
place. Well, it can cause physical illness as well. Oh, everybody knows that. Yeah.
I mean, goodness gracious. I want to show my age. But, you know, 20 years ago, I didn't think about people dying. But boy, people I went to high school now, I hear about, they're dying. Wow. You know, it's just that time. You know, this year, both my wife's parents died. This last year. Ba-boom! They were doing fine. Everything was going along. Mm. They were doing their stuff. But they were gone. That's the way it works. You know? And we're encouraging people, there's a better way. There's a happier way. But there is not a, and I want to make this very clear, Peggy, there is not a passive, happier way. You know, that's kind of like with the government we got. It's like, oh, just hang around, it'll all work out. No, it won't.
So we have to be the ones to move forward and make decisions and get involved.
We have to step up.
And because if we take the step to do that, then we will become more fulfilled and be able to function better in the years to come. Is that what you're saying?
Without a doubt. It's weird. It seems like the way I get better is work on me. That's what the world tells us. Work on you, you'll get better. And I have not found that.
Okay.
I have not found that, Peggy. That when people get wrapped up in themselves, they get weird. But when I go look around to the people that I admire, that I like, when I hear, and I love this, hearing stories of the back in the day, You know, I always love, you know, I grew up in Oklahoma, mm-hmm. and so I love hearing about old South Carolina. People telling me, you know, to get to Myrtle Beach, you used to have to drive a two-lane highway. and they talk about cars overheating.
Yeah.
Wow. So there was a commitment. You didn't just get in the car and say, let's go to Myrtle Beach. That had to be purposeful. But the memories, 40 years later, they're still having those memories.
Sure.
They're still excited. And that's how humans work, is that when you go out and do for other people, when you're involved in other people's lives, it comes back and it blesses you. And it affects your mood. Unbeknownst, you get happier. And it just seems weird. I help other people and I get better. Yeah. I do for other people and I get happier. Yeah. Wow. And we've lost that. We've told people that didn't work. In the 50s, that's what people did. People were happier, you know? Yeah. And here we are years later, and we've given that up, and then we wonder why we're miserable. And we didn't realize how good we had it. But there are people who remember. You know, there are people who are still alive who know you got to get up and get with it. You got to be involved. You got to be a participant.
We have more stuff than any generation has ever had. But to say that we are happier or better off, I don't think so. And so maybe we can put aside this year some of the stuff and put other people ahead of all that.
Amen.
And we'll all be blessed. Is that
without
that's
a doubt,
your message?
And
okay.
And I say, test me. Put me to the test. Take this message.
Okay.
And put me to the test.
All right.
Help other people and get worse.
All of us. And wherever you are, that's what we wish for you, a blessed time in the months to come, and that we can all change for the better.
Amen.
God bless you. We'll see you next time.